President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. hails what he calls improvement in the Philippine government's campaign against illegal drugs. Marcos reported over 27,000 villages have been declared drug-free. Meanwhile, more than 100 police officers are already facing charges over several violations linked to the drug trade. Around 10 billion pesos worth of illegal drugs were also confiscated last year.
Para sa amin, hindi lang ito sa mga magandang numero. Kung hindi ay talagang magiging improvement, pinapaganda talaga natin ang komunidad natin, pinapaganda talaga natin ang buhay ng ating mga kababayan at iniiwas natin ang mga kabataan natin dyan sa pagpasok sa lifestyle ng drug taking.
A human rights watchdog also welcomes the president's report.
This is certainly sending the right message to the international community, to the families of victims, of the thousands of victims of the drug war, that things are happening no matter how little it can be. We've always argued that for impunity to be stopped, there needs to be accountability and, investigating police officers who are misbehaving. Certainly, you wouldn't imagine this happening under the Duterte administration.
The report comes as International Criminal Court moves ahead with its probe on the Duterte administration's drug war. Marcos has rejected cooperating with the investigation, but he later said he is studying the country's possible return to the ICC. More government agencies denying involvement in the alleged charter change bribery scheme. The Philippine Health Department asserts it will only give medical assistance to patients proven to be indigent and financially incapacitated. The Labor Department also clears its name in the issue.
Hindi po mapapahintulutan ng DOLE na kami maging kasangkapan sa mga gawain na hindi naman po angkop sa batas.
Several lawmakers have flagged the supposed campaign by local officials, urging their constituents to support Chacha in exchange for money. Albay Representative Edsel Lagman, who first raised the issue, is now questioning if the charter amendment agenda was included in this year's national budget.
Palagay ko merong second phase itong amendment agenda at ito yung mga substantial amendment to the constitution. For example, yung liberalization of economic policies and possibly extension of term limits. Kaya malaki itong pundong ito na ilinaan.
The Philippine government appealing to Indonesia once again to grant clemency to Mary Jane Veloso, a Filipino worker sentenced to death for drug trafficking. The request was made as Indonesian President Joko Widodo arrives in Manila for a 3-day visit. Katrina Domingo reports.
Indonesian President Joko Widodo arrived in Manila Tuesday evening for a 3-day official visit, months before the Philippines and Indonesia marked 75 years of bilateral relations. Among the issues Philippine officials raised with their Indonesian counterparts before the Indonesian leader's arrival, a reiteration of a request to grant an executive clemency for Filipina death row convict Mary Jane Veloso.
I raised the issue. We're taking the steps we're taking to address it. Sinabi ko lang anong ginagawa natin ngayon with also what Indonesia is doing, and we're working to see whether we can find a way towards resolving the case, yung clemency.
But when asked if President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. will personally raise the issue anew with the Indonesian president during their bilateral meeting in Malacanang, Manalo says they will see how the discussions will go. Veloso was arrested in Yogyakarta, Indonesia in April 2010 after authorities found 2.6 kilograms of heroin sewn into the lining of her luggage. The Nueva Ecija native pleaded her innocence, telling Indonesian courts that the luggage she used was given by her recruiters. The Philippines has been appealing Veloso's conviction for years, underscoring that the Filipina is a victim of trafficking and that she was not given a translator who could explain to her what was happening during her trial. Marcos Jr. first asked his Indonesian counterpart about a possible clemency for Veloso in 2022 when the Filipino leader flew to Jakarta for a state visit. Indonesian Foreign Minister Retno Marsudi did not comment on the Philippines' plea for Veloso. But she thanked the Philippine government for facilitating the safe return of hundreds of Indonesian trafficking victims to their home country last year.
All this cooperation with on migration is part of ASEAN cooperation. So we have always helped our ASEAN neighbors and that, just like we seek their help on similar issues. It's always been our position to see whether they can grant clemency. That's always been the position of the Philippines. Now it's up to their government to decide.
Meantime, still ahead of Jokowi's official visit, the Philippines and Indonesia reaffirmed their commitment to forge closer ties. The two countries also vowed to address regional and world issues together, with the Indonesian foreign minister saying that Southeast Asia's largest economy will work with ASEAN members to finalize a code of conduct in the South China Sea.
This is an important step to ensure the South China Sea remains a sea of peace, stability, and prosperity. We will seize the momentum to strengthen our bilateral ties in various sectors of mutual interest and to address regional and global challenges together.
Marsudi adds Indonesia is also committed to explore more investment opportunities in the Philippines. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres. Hi, Veronica.
Hi, good morning, and to all of our audience too in ANC. So, as of now, the northeast monsoon is affecting northern and central Luzon, while easterlies is affecting the rest of the country. So, we're expecting cloudy skies with light rains over Cagayan Valley and Aurora due to northeast monsoon. Partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated light rains is expected over Ilocos Region, Cordillera Administrative Region, and the rest of central Luzon. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms is expected. We don't have gale warning rays over any parts of the country, but extreme northern Luzon and the eastern sections of southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao may be expecting moderate to rough seas. As of now, we're not monitoring any low-pressure area or tropical cyclone near or inside the Philippine area of responsibility. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Veronica.